Hi, Mrs. Ellison. It's your second daughter here. Not really, but sometimes that is how it makes me feel with how inclusive you are. And when you come to visit Bailey in our wonderful apartment that you helped us find. So Bailey asked me and others to make this video because she knows the outpouring of support that you would receive, and I'm glad to just be one of them here chatting with you for your Christmas day. I know things have been a little bit tough lately, but I genuinely hope that your days start to look a little brighter and a little bit better. You've handled everything that has gone on over the past few months with such grace and a big smile, and it's honestly inspiring. I don't think the past few months have been easy for anyone in really any stage of life. It seems like the end of 2017 has kind of sucked for everybody. But I'm glad that we're all heading into a new year with health and happiness and just moving on together. I just wanted to say that Griffin and Bailey are so lucky to look up to and learn from a mom like you, and I really can't wait to see the people that they grow into because of you. I hope this video and how everyone came together for you on your Christmas day just makes you smile and that you go into the new year with a fresh and fantastic mindset. And we love you, and I hope you have a wonderful Christmas.
Hi, Miss Robin. I look like actual death because I just got out of the shower. But that's besides the point. I just wanted to say that I think you're honestly one of the best friends' moms that I have. You always make us pancakes in the morning whenever I spend the night at your house. You always ask questions about my life and everyone else's life, which is just nice, and not many moms do that, you know? I feel like you just know how to be a good, fun, but not like too fun, not like the mom on Mean Girls fun. I just feel like you know how to be a good mom, and that's not something you see often, and I really appreciate it. And you're also such a beautiful woman, and to me, you look like Jennifer Aniston. I just want to say that. I've always thought that since I like met you when I was younger because my mom's obsessed with the Friends show. Anyways, yay! Love.
Hey, Miss Robin, it's Sydney here, and I just wanted to take the time and send you some love this year, and let you know how awesome of a person I think that you are. You know, I've always thought you were a great person, and I know you always will be just because that's who you are. You're just so nice and so kind, and let you know you've always been that way since middle school, since I've known you, which is crazy because we're seniors in college now, but you've always been so welcoming and, you know, genuinely concerned about people. I think that's just who you are. But just always wanting to catch up and see how we've been. I just really haven't taken it for granted. You know, people like you can't take for granted. And I just wanted to let you know how appreciative I am of you. And I hope you have a great holiday this year.
Hi, Miss Robin. It's Reagan. I feel weird for saying Miss Robin because I feel like we're so much closer than that. Anyways, I just wanted to tell you how awesome of a person I think that you are. You are a terrific mother. I should know because you're practically a second mother to me. You are just an all-around genuine person. Every single time I come to the house to hang out with Bailey, you always ask me how I'm doing, even if I haven't been there in a while. And I don't know, I just love it. You always ask how I'm doing. You always are concerned with my life or wanting to know more. And even if I, again, even if I haven't been there, been to y'all's house in a while, I feel like we pick things back up right where they were. So, I don't know. There's so much more I need to say, and I've tried to take so many videos to think of it, but I don't know. You're just an all-around great person, and I'm so glad you and Bailey are in my life, and I hope you have a terrific Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Hey, Miss Ellison. I just wanted to say Merry Christmas, and I wanted to tell you how amazing of a person you are, and how much of an influence you have been on me in my life. You know, you were there for me when nobody else was. You know, in my situation, my family and I, we ran to you. You're like a mom to me, and I will never, like, I don't know how to repay you. I want to say thank you so much for everything you've done for me and being there for me. You know, you're like, you're my mom. You're definitely my mom, and I love you. I don't know if you know that or I've ever told you that, but I really do love you, and you're an amazing person. Again, thank you for being there. Like this situation with my leg, you were there for me in the hospital and the ambulance. Thank you for everything you've done, and I don't know how I ever pay you, but you're amazing.
Merry Christmas, Robin. I have many memories of us. I moved down to Rock Hill, South Carolina, and had no friends, and you guys lived next door and shortly became family. One of my fondest memories is when Bella was a baby and she would not stop crying, so you taught me how to put her in a football hold. And that stuck with me for the longest, so thank you very much. I appreciate our friendship. I adore you. I hope all is well, and I wish you all a Merry Christmas.
Hi, Robin. This is Jessica, your old neighbor. I am laying in bed after Aiden's birthday party because I am in a lot of pain. 9 7-year-old boys. Today. It was super fun though. Bailey had asked us to send videos of how wonderful and how you have influenced our lives. And I just wanted to let you know I've always looked up to you as a parent and wanted to try to be the best mother I could be, neighbor and friend, because of you. I miss you living across the street from me. I have always respected and looked up to you and always thought you were super beautiful and classy. And I just wanted to let you know that. I hope this makes it into her collage of videos. I apologize I never got the kids in with me and or Michael, which just are never all well behaved or showered and looking good at the same time. Life of a mother. I love you and I wish you the best. Have a very Merry Christmas and I will talk to you soon. Bye bye.
Hi, Robin. I just wanted to tell you that I really admire your strength and your courage. You have done so much these last few months that a lot of women just couldn't pull up the bootstraps and do. I know 2018 is going to be a fantastic year for you and a brand new start. Just want you to know that you are very appreciated and loved by many and only wish the best for you.
Hi, Robin. Merry Christmas. I know we haven't known each other that long, but I'm so glad you're in my life. I hope you have a great 2018. Merry Christmas.
Hi, Robin. Happy birthday. You are such a special person to so many of us. And you know, you're my conjoined twin because we went through national board together and you've always been there for me. And I love you dearly. And you are such a blessing and a gift to all the students that you've helped over the years at Ebenezer, then at Rawlson Road, and now at ATC. I love you and happy birthday.
Hey, Robin. We are wanting to wish you a Merry Christmas. Hope you're feeling better. We miss you. We love you. And please come and see us sometime soon. And I'm going to hand it over to Kathy.
Hey, Robin, my phenomenal friend. I am so proud of you and I love you. I look at all the challenges that you've been through and nothing stops you because you're unstoppable and invincible. And that's what I love about you. And I'm so excited. I can't wait for you to invite me over to your new house. And I'm looking at this new adventure for you as a new beginning. So when God closes one door, another one opens. And I know you guys are going to be fine. And I'm so excited. You know I'm your number one fan and your number one cheerleader. And this is going to be an awesome Christmas. Contact me because I want to come over and see the house. I love you. Take care. Get better so we can hang out some more. Love you, girl. Merry Christmas.
And we love you. We love you here. We miss you.
Bye.
Hope to see you soon.
Hey, Robin. my longtime friend. I just want to wish you and Bailey and Griffin a Merry Christmas, you in particular. I know this has been a year of change for you, and I want you to look at it as a positive change. I can't wait to see what the new year holds for you. You're such an awesome young lady, and I just know that God's going to bless you with lots of good things for all the good that you have done for others. I love you lots.
Hey, Robin, it's Kelly. First of all, I'm so honored that Bailey asked me to be a part of your videos to show you how much we appreciate you and love you. I know this year has been hard for you, but always know that I think the world of you. You are a strong and courageous lady and can tackle anything. You're beautiful inside and out, and we love you for who you are. You've been a great friend. You were a wonderful neighbor over in Channing Park. You've been an even better neighbor over in Laurel Creek. And I hate to see you leaving, but know that I'm just a phone call or a text away. Just pick up the phone, because you always have a friend in me. And I will miss you, but I know much happiness will come to you, because you're just that kind of person. You can light up a room, and you have a great personality, and I wish you the best. Take care. I love you. Bye.
Hi, Robin.
Hi, Robin. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, and what a nice daughter you have doing this for you.
Very nice
daughter.
We
tried to remember any good memories we had.
Yes.
They all involved getting in trouble. We're not really sure why. But...
skipping school senior year.
Oh, yeah. There's other things we won't say.
Yes, yes.
But we're just saying hi.
We miss you.
Bye.
Love you. Bye. Merry Christmas.
Hello, Robin. This is your fellow 1987 Buckeye graduate friend, Jennifer Januska Coyne, saying hello after all these years. I believe the last time I saw you was at Christine Kiesel Vanessel's wedding, so I hope you're doing well. It seems that way. I'm glad to keep up with everybody on social media and Facebook. I'm sending you this video as a request from your lovely daughter, who wanted to put a nice montage of nice things about you for Christmas. So my memory that I'm going to share is from our back in the day in high school. I believe we had speed writing class together with Mrs. Harbath. I could be saying it wrong. I think that's the class we had together, at least one of them that I remember. And you used to come in all the time with your leg warmers on and your ankle weights underneath them. And I always thought that was such an inspiration for somebody who was so physically fit and so dedicated to wear that stuff to school every day. And I believe then I started doing aerobics, and I didn't wear the leg warmers because I wasn't that brave, but I do believe I tried to do like a 20-minute workout video or something like that in the big Jane Fonda era. So I hope that's a nice memory that you remember. You were always very sweet in school, and I can tell your daughter is exactly the same way, for her to contact all the strangers and get us to put a nice little video montage for you. So I hope you enjoy it, and I hope you have a nice holiday season, and your daughter's super sweet for doing it, and I can't wait to see you maybe at a future reunion. Take care, bye.
Hey Robin, it's Jen, and Bailey asked me to be a part of this video, and I was thrilled when she included me. So two words on that, kiddo: parenting win. Seems like a fantastic person, and I love the fact that she's going to be an RN, so yay, good for you and the hubby of yours. But anyway, I started thinking, I don't remember a lot about high school, to tell you the truth. It's been a long time, and I have a crappy memory. So I went through the first and only scrapbook I've ever made in my life, and I did it in 1987 and haven't looked at it in probably 25 or so years. So this was a amazing trip down memory lane, and I realized that really the three most important people in my life through high school seemed to be Kevin, Wendy, and then you, looking through this book. So I was wondering if you wanted to go on a little journey down memory lane with me. So I'm going to stop this video and turn the video around, and then let's talk then. Okay. So here it is, 1987 Buckeye Bucks scrapbook. Really, like I said, the first and only
book I've ever made. Boy, I was a big nerd back then. I wish somebody would have told me. But there's the first page, so we all know who that guy is. But I see these little yellow tabs. I went through, and although you're through the whole book, these are some of the bigger memories. And this first one was Christmas at Higbee's. I even saved the key. I can't even believe I saved the key. Do you remember? Because the key was right. The lighting is bad in this room. Right there, me, you, and Wynn, and the keys, and I think, look at your hand. Do you remember that? You were, I think you were playing with his itty-bitty little hairs on his head. I think that's exactly what was going on. So that was Mr. Jingling, and then Higbee's, all three of us. And look, you, such a model back then and even now today. Look at how you're posing, which I found pretty funny to look back on. Oh, and then for some reason I have all your prom pictures. Don't ask me why. There's Kevin, prom king, all sweaty. And then there's you and Jim, and you and, who is that, Tom? I don't even remember that guy. But it's funny that I have your prom pictures. This, you're going to freak out. Look at the, wait, hold on. Not that I love you forever. Hold on a second. See, I think that card's from you. Oh, that's all Kevin. Went to Genesis. But this, look at this. Look, that's from your baby sister. I bet you, I'm not sure, but I bet you her writing has gotten better. Anyway, I thought that was really cute, and I can't believe I saved it. So, anyway, that was from April. And then look at what a big nerd I am. Cotillion, I just was invited by you, but boy, I made a big deal about that, and I was really proud of you, so I did this, and I think there's other people back there, underneath there, but I didn't care about anybody then. The spring charity ball, and then your all fancy formal invitation, pretty neat, and that was May 5th, 1987, pretty impressive. We went to Florida, had a good time, got stupid, there's you and I believe Kiesel there, and then more prom pictures, and then I guess I saved, and I don't save cards, so that's crazy, but I think that's from you. I don't save cards, so this is funny that I did yours and Kevin's, and you're all the way through this and giving me support and understanding, and they're really at every step of the way. And boy, we were chatty. Look, I haven't even reread these, but not on that one. Oh yeah, there you go. There's, but anyway, I think that's pretty much it. Like I said, I wasn't a big scrapbooker, but look at all those pink tabs. And that just really reminded me, oh, and I believe this one was from you too. Reminded me how important that of a person you were through junior high. I'm gonna stop this and switch it around again so I can talk with you rather than have you listen to the table. So I switched the camera back around, and anyway, thanks for being who you were and who we were back then, and it did mean the world to me. I absolutely love Facebook because I'm able to watch you. Your kids grow and what you're doing, and stalk you a little bit. healthy stalking. I just wish you guys the best. And if it ever comes to a point where you want to get up to Alaska for a visit, our door is always open. So I'll always have some love for you. And I know Kevin feels the same. And Merry Christmas. And again, Bailey, nice work, sweetheart. All right, take care. Bye bye, my friend.
Hey, Robin, it's Kevin. Delana, in case you can figure that out. I guess Bailey, you've got a pretty good kid there. She's putting together a little video montage of people from your past. So I guess I don't know what to say other than, it's funny where life takes you and the things you remember when you were kids. One of the things I really remember as a kid was when our parents would kind of get together after church, and I was like, oh, come on, man, I really don't want to go. Football's on now, and I need to get home and watch the game. But then going to your house, it wasn't always so bad, because I remember that Yeah, the secret's probably out. I think you were my first crush when I was like 8 years old or something like that. Yeah, well, you can put that dirt back in the bag anyway. So anyway, I hope everything's treating you well. We think about you, and we miss seeing you, and you're always welcome to come see us, and hopefully we can see you sometime. But hope the holidays go well, and I hope you know we love you, Roman. Okay, bye.
Robin Frigius, Jeff Shade here. I hope you're doing well. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. It's been a long time. You know, you're one state over from where I'm at, which is, it's inexcusable that we haven't gotten our families together. We need to do that at some point in time. But I'm very happy that Bailey asked me to do this. And Bailey, I'm very sorry it took me so long. You had to chase me. So I do apologize. And Robin, I really do hope that you're going to have a wonderful Christmas. This seems like a really great gift that Bailey's doing. Just a couple things that I remember. You know, one, your daughter Bailey looks just like you did in high school. It's very eerie of the similarities. And I mean that as the utmost compliment. Also, your mom was just a tremendous roller skater. You know, all the guys, we all wanted to roller skate with her in elementary school. And yes, Robin, I still remember seventh grade. You were my first girlfriend. So I do cherish those moments. I hope to see you soon, and I hope you guys just have a wonderful Christmas and a Happy New Year.
All right, nobody knows what to say. How about I just wander around, you guys talk, I'll break into your conversation. I'll break in your conversation, and you can say, "Hi, Robin."
Oh,
we're talking
about earliest memories.
My earliest memories. We'll take any memories. That's eggnog. What are you drinking?
I won't go by memory. With some eggnog. I guess I'll just say. Yeah.
Or you know what else is good?
I'm sorry for your situation.
Is the.
I know it's hard to go through.
The one I like.
Nothing that anybody would like. It's probably hard right now, but over time you'll figure out that it's for the best. And once things settle down.
Jade and your apples. Margie said your apples.
Things will work out in the end, but up until then I know it'll be difficult. But just
so your apple
keep
is
moving
good.
Forward, and you'll come out better towards at the end, I guess. But looking forward to seeing you again. I'll stop there.
All right. Thank you, Nathan.
Oh, no.
Who's next?
April.
Hi, Pop.
Not Pop, sis.
No, Lollipop.
Lollipop, okay.
Yeah, she used to call me Lolly.
Really?
Uh-huh.
Didn't know that.
Yeah. I already sent Robin a letter saying all the things I think about her awesome new future as an independent woman.
All right.
And I think it's going to be a really great time for her. It's like going to be like a new life.
Yep.
I mean, really, like, I was like, wow, like, Bailey and Griffin are out of the house, and, like, now she's got this, like, really wonderful time to be, like, a single woman. Who,
finding herself again.
Yeah, like, a whole new beginning. Not only that, but, like, strong woman, independent. She's already, you know, she's got her career under her belt. She knows what she's doing. So now it's just like go out there and find some cool men.
Oh, geez.
Some dates.
Little early.
I'm serious. It's gonna
no,
be awesome.
No.
It's gonna be. I mean, I did that when I moved to Pittsburgh. It was so much fun.
Well, what do you?
It was
that on the rebound. You don't want to have somebody.
No,
on the
it's not rebound. It's just dating. You're not looking for. I mean, she's saying she has to get married again. She doesn't have to get married. She just wants a date.
Okay.
You send her some dating sites that work?
Oh God, I think
Quarkass.com.
I was saying talk to this one because she's I haven't dated in a while since Pittsburgh.
She's getting out going there.
I mean, when I was doing dating, it was right before Tinder. So I'm kind of glad I missed the Tinder movement. That was more just hookups, right?
Okay.
What was it? It was, I don't remember what site we met on. Craig and I met online. No, not Match. Nothing we paid for. Don't pay for dating sites.
Alright. Who's next?
I'll go. I don't know what to say. I'm just going to go on. It's like, you might have to delete it.
It's kind of simple.
Okay. The dating site.
Hi. Oh, yeah. Merry Christmas.
I'm wearing it out.
I love when you call me back because you bring so much positive energy and it makes everybody happy. I'm sorry about the situation that's happening right now, but at the end of every bad situation, there's always something good that happens. And you're still young and beautiful and still working. And I miss you and love you. And you can text me or call me anytime if you need to talk. And yeah. Bye, love you.
That was good. That was almost a minute. All right, Coach. When everybody else talks, we hear you. Your turn.
I thought you went upstairs to.
Nobody would go upstairs.
Classic mom move. That's mom. It would be a video to Robin if it wasn't mom in the background, either showing her butt or talking.
Hey, right? Watch the showing your butt. Hey,
Linda,
you're
talking to Robin.
Right now, I'm eating pumpkin pie made by Jaden here, and it is delicious. And I want to say Merry Christmas. And since it's Thanksgiving, I'll say Happy Thanksgiving. Since I didn't call you, let's see. What do I want to say? It's really that I got your back. I do. I'm thinking of you all the time, and you know you can call me for anything. And I'm always. Always praying that all the good stuff comes to you. I mean, it will. It will. Let's see. Just keep a good outlook on life. Stay the Robin, the energetic Robin that you are. And everything will be just fine. Mama knows. Mama knows everything. So, you'll be all right. And then I want to say I love you. And Macy, come here. Come here, Macy. Look at this girl. You remember when we were there and she was just a puppy? Look at there. That's for look.
Nothing to do with you.
No.
Now she gives kisses. Get a kiss.
Kiss.
Yuck. Oh, yuck.
Call her.
Macy, come here. What do I want to call her for?
Because that's for Robin.
Oh.
Say something, Macy. Say hi, Robin.
I don't think she's going to take pictures.
Somebody else going to say Merry Christmas.
Let me get Stable here. I'll get Stable here.
She looking at you?
She is looking at us. All right.
Is it on?
Who's that? Oh, yeah, we're running. We are running.
It's Thanksgiving, but really just...
Yeah,
that's right. Super turkey.
Merry Christmas, Aunt Robin. Can't wait to meet you.
That's Robin's niece?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I have to think about it. Yeah.
Yeah. Not used to that.
Like, how are we going to come?
How old is she now?
Now she's almost six weeks on Sunday, so okay. 5.5 weeks.
And she weighs?
Probably when she sees her, probably if we go to Bailey's, it'll be like May. So she'll be.
How much does she weigh now?
Be like 8 months then. She weighs 10.5 pounds right now. Ooh. She's a big chunker.
Tubby.
Big chunker. She's tired.
Uh-huh.
She's big. She had a lot of turkey.
She
said she can't wait to meet you.
And a lot of pictures taken.
A lot of pictures. She can come for the pictures.
Okay.
She's good now.
All right. Coming around to Grandma.
Let's get the Three Musketeers here. Yeah, we're all going to get together here. Family.
Oh, we're going to be the whole family, all right?
That's a cute picture right
Robin,
there.
You know where we are. We're up and we wish you were here, too. But I understand you'll be here at one point or another. Say something, Mom.
Well, I'm so glad to be with everybody here. It's been my happy day. Look forward to see my new granddaughter. And she sure is sweet. I did tell... April, leave that baby with me and you can have the other one.
Robin, I think she's serious.
She didn't give me no answer. Wish I don't get an asteroid. And how are you doing, Robin? Wish you could have been with us. We miss you.
That would have been nice.
We'll catch you next time, Robin. I look forward to seeing you at home. Best wishes and blessings.
Thank you.
Love you.
All right, we good?
Yeah.
All right.
Somebody's got to get done.
Where's Margaret?
Oh, yeah. I'll do it. Yeah, let Jay do it.
I am right here.
Yeah.
the camera girl.
No, I don't know.
All right. All right. They're forcing the cameraman to show his face.
Hold still.
That's right. Yeah, I get everybody.
All right. What say, Nathan? I couldn't hear you. Can you speak up a little bit?
What one do I click the record?
It's running.
It is?
Yeah, just play it.
You'll end it.
You see my face?
Yep.
Do you see the box move?
Yep.
Well, then it's following my face.
Yep.
All right. Robin, daughter, South Carolina. You all come home now, you hear?
Oh,
wait a minute. We got a baby biting your mother over here. She's likes holding that baby. She misses you. She misses your children. Hope all is going well with them in school. I know you were worried financially. I don't know where you're at right now, but as far as I know, they're still in school. Bailey's going to graduate. We're going to hustle on down there to see the graduation. I can hardly wait for that. And Griffin, he's going to where? Clemson?
Mm-hmm.
So he's getting to be a big boy. And like they say, they're getting out of the house. And I'm sorry, but I don't know any good dating sites for you. But if you give me a little time, I can try doing a little research for you. But keep your chin up. You know, I always say, keep smiling. Did I try to set her up?
Yeah.
Well, if she has some cute girlfriends, I'd like that.
Okay, you're down there.
Mom didn't hear that, did you?
I'm sending you a
smile. All right, daughter. All right. I love you. Keep your chin up. Keep smiling. Things will work out for the best. They will.
Hi, Robin. Merry Christmas. We love and miss you. Hopefully you're doing well, and I hope to see you when we visit home next. Bye.
So.
It's just going to your aunt.
Hey, Aunt Robin. Thanks for always being a great godmother and being supportive and always giving us good advice growing up. I still have the book you gave me when my friend passed away, and it meant a lot to me and helped me get through a hard time. Hope all has been well and hope to see you soon. Miss you. Love you. Have a Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas,
Merry
Robin.
Merry Christmas, Robin.
We miss you.
I hope you have a great new year in your new home.
We love you and we can't wait to see you again.
Yeah, we can see your house and I want to see it.
Yeah, we
want
to see it.
And I wish I can hug you and kiss you.
We'll have to plan a trip with the new baby.
Yep.
And Mommy's getting a new baby and it's going to be a boy. Name is going to be Robert.
Oh, yeah.
Hello, yeah. Bye. Merry Christmas.
Bye.
Merry Christmas, dear Robin.
Happy New Year.
I wish I could be there.
Say Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Can't wait to see you again.
Can't wait to see you again.
Say miss you. Say miss you.
I miss you.
Miss you.
Say congratulations on your new house.
Congratulations on your new house.
Do you guys want to go see your new house?
Yeah.
Yeah? What do you think it looks like?
Pink and purple.
You think it's pink and purple? What do you think it looks like?
I hope it's better than the last house.
Why? That last house was nice.
I know.
You hope it's better?
But if it's better than this next house.
What do you think it looks like? What color?
Oops.
No guesses?
I don't know.
How many bedrooms?
Like
maybe. Merry Christmas, dear Robin.
Say bye.
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 Bye. Wait, bye, man. Say bye.
Bye. Bye.
Bye.
Daddy! Hi, Aunt Robin. This is Shelby, sending you my love from Spain. Sorry, my eyes are watering because it's really cold and my heat's not working. Anyways, I just wanted to say that I hope you're having a wonderful Christmas and I love you and I miss you and I'm really, really thankful for the, the wonderful role model that you've been for my whole life. And I can't film this without crying because I know things have been hard for you lately, but I just wanted to send you my love and say that I'm really grateful for the beautiful, kind-hearted, wonderful person you are. And I love you. Okay, bye.
Merry Christmas, Grandma! Gee, I love you. Yeah. Saying thank you for being such an amazing grandma and for spoiling me while my mommy's not here. Gee, I love you.
Okay. Hey, Mom. I just want to let you know I'm thankful for you. And I know it's tough right now, but things are going to get better. I love you. The best is yet to come. And Merry Christmas.
Okay. So, Mom, I really hope you liked the video that I put together for you. I just wanted to let you know how grateful I am to have a mom as amazing and incredible as you. You have literally always been there for me and Griffin throughout everything we've needed. You know, you've always done all of our birthday, Easter, Christmas shopping, everything like that. And you've always been at all of our sporting events, and you've just always been there for us. And I know, like, a lot of moms don't do that. Like, they're not always there all the time. And I know me and Griffin both really appreciate that. Let's see. You have been and are my role model. I have always looked up to you. I think part of the reason I want to work with kids is because you do, and I've always kind of wanted to be you. So we'll see. Everyone says I look like you, so almost there. Let's see. There are really just no words to describe how thankful I know me and Griffin both are for you, because you're just amazing. And I know that we couldn't ask for a better mom. You are literally like 200, I don't know where I'm going with this, 200 on a scale of, I don't know, forget that. Okay, so I love you so much. And I hope that things get better for you, and I know they will. And we just both want you to be happy, and I hope you know that people care about you and they love you. And that was part of the purpose of this video, was to make sure you know how much we all love you. Yeah, so Merry Christmas. We love you. Merry Christmas, Mom. We love you.